Hey everybody, Chris Pearson here with NebuloCity. Thanks so much for joining. The last couple of weeks have been insane. We've had everything from bottomed out temperatures near 0 degrees Fahrenheit, where it felt like you were in Antarctica, all the way up to 60 degrees and we're just on the verge of sort of spring weather. It's just been insane. And so it sort of made planning really difficult, and that's part of the reason why I've been so delayed in my last video. I apologize for that. But it's just, it's been sort of a learning process for me above and beyond normal things. But in any case, we did manage to get out there, and boy, I don't know about you guys, but the conditions were pretty much as bad as you can imagine. Not only were the winds up there, 15, 20 miles an hour, but you had just rock solid ice on the hillside that I normally do my Astro work. It was just solid. I mean, I felt like I was skating on ice. I finally got up to the top of the hill and I said, let me go ahead and see if I can clear some area here. And I mean, you can see, the chunks of ice that were pretty much throughout the entire area were impenetrable, And so I did my best and I tried to shoot something simple. I said, the moon's out, it's about 60, 70% illuminated. Why don't we go after something not a nebula, not a galaxy. Let's go after a star cluster. Even better, let's go after an open star cluster, something really wide that kind of suits my RedCat 51 setup. And so I went after M44, the Beehive Cluster. And, it was an interesting experience trying to shoot, broadband images with a partially lit moon. There's a lot of, videos and research about how to do that or how not to do that. So what I sort of did was I used the IDAS or IDAS D2 light pollution suppression filter on my RedCat 51 and my ASI2600MC Pro. I went ahead and set that stuff up and I started to take some initial images, and it was working up fairly decent until the wind started to pick up again and the the tracking just went all haywire and it just wasn't fun. Not to mention the fact that I was wearing, three layers of shirts, three layers of pants, two layers of socks. I had my little hand warmers. I mean, it was crazy. So, but, I got to see the object for the first time. And incidentally, the next day, it actually was a little bit better. So I went back out to the same site. And fortunately, a lot of the snow and ice had sort of melted on the hillside so I could get, better footing, better traction to get my gear up there. And shoot a little bit more of that same object to get a little bit more data. And so ultimately, I produced two images, one in just black and white, sort of monochrome color. It's sort of a beginner object. It wasn't a whole lot of data, I think maybe an hour or two, but it was pretty cool. And then ultimately, I was able to sort of edit that and add some of that additional data, my flats, my darks, my bias frames. And as I was able to produce a rough color image. It was a little bit tricky to do, again, because I just had such limited data, but I thought it was pretty cool. So, those two objects are pretty neat, and, overall, it was a good experience. It's my first open cluster, and I hope I get a chance to do a whole lot more of them, down the line. So, having said that, a couple days passed, and the moon just kept getting brighter and brighter, and ultimately, there were 2 days of open weather. So, I went out and I shot the Horsehead Nebula for the very first time. I swapped out filters. Instead of using the D2 filter, that broadband filter, which is really great for LED lighting, by the way, if you haven't used that filter before and you're in Bortle class 8-9 skies with a lot of LED lights, totally recommend it. It's a wonderful filter. But in any case, with the Horsehead Nebula, and the brighter moon, I went really aggressive. And I put on there an L-Extreme filter by Optolong in my train and, started taking images, and I was able to get sort of between 2 to 4 hours of really good information. And, I'll show you kind of what I was able to produce at the end of the video, but it was an interesting experience. A lot of light pollution, as you can see here, just an incredible amount of sort of bright, in the area. But at the same time, for my sort of suburban area, it actually is relatively dark, in that little area there in that field that I took those images in. So overall, it's been a great experience. I got a chance to sort of test my gear in the coldest elements and test my will and determination in getting stuff out in some of the most difficult conditions. And, sometimes things work out, sometimes they don't. But I think in the end, you know, these three images, sort of the, you know, the black and white monochrome version of the Open Star Cluster, the Beehive Cluster, the colorized version of it, as well as, you know, the Horsehead Nebula, my first Horsehead Nebula, you know, it was a wonderful experience for me. And I'm happy that I was able to share this with all of you guys. So hopefully all of you out there who have been shooting the night skies through similar conditions in the last couple of weeks, hopefully you guys have had some success. You know, share some feedback in the comments. Let me know what you think about the star clusters, whether or not you like the black and white version or you like the color version, or you like both or you don't like either. Long story short, it's been a fun couple of weeks. I'm really looking forward to winter ending and spring coming about. I know that it's galaxy season, and I'm really excited to see what all you guys are able to post online and what I'm able to produce as well. So until then, again, best of luck to you guys, and as always, clear skies. What's up, guys? Do another video here. Just testing stuff out.